Okay, Gran Turismo Sport, career rather than online. I want to finish the game before moving to Gran Turismo 7. I still have quite a lot left to do. I came to Gran Turismo quite late and moved pretty much straight away to online. So haven't done much of the career, which is really bad in this game, but still I want to finish it. Okay, actually I have no idea what kind of gearbox this car has, so that's quite interesting. I actually see it. Oh, I cannot. Horrible. I can see he's actually moving his hand there, so I guess it's a normal manual. Oh, my gear was not going to work. I switched to H shifter after I run the game, which means it's not going to work. I would have to restart the game, which I'm not going to do. But I guess I could actually switch to sequential at least. Let's see if I can do it. It would be really hard to do it. Maybe I'm going to pause it and do it. Okay. Let's find a switch here. Why it's so hard? What should be easy? Here we go. That should work. Thanks for leaving so much space outside. Sequential instead of H, but just to be honest, I don't even know what the car has. my watch tells me I should start moving. Well, I am. I'm moving my hands, right? In that corner, but who cares? It's Gran Turismo, as the course are which cars, so. There is no difficulty slider, and the AI is really horrible in that game. Someone can ask why I've even bothered to do the career in that game. Or that single player mode, which it's hard to call career at all. Well, there is that achievement for level 50, right? Achieving level 50 player level, which is just crazy. It's such a huge grind, I can't imagine. I'm level 40 at the moment. I don't know how I'm going to do the level 50. I think it will be the longest achievement to do, and it's not even hard, it's just grind, grind and grind. So I guess finishing every single race in the game will help to get that experience for the further levels. I'm not even sure. It's 1200 for with the bonus. I guess those lower tier races don't give that much in terms of experience. Hopefully be able to get more in the higher tier levels races. Okay, so next race, Red Bull Ring, at least a cool track, Austria. What cars do we have? I guess something from Germany, close enough, right? Maybe BMW. There's one BMW I have and I haven't chance to drive yet, which is the Z8. Okay, this one. Okay, so we need to modify it a bit. First of all, reduce that traction control to zero and reduce the power. Soft, if I can, why not to? What's the point? And let's see how it goes. Vantage, M4, Countach, AMG45, Miura, R34, and so on. Drive, nothing else to do. Oh, if there's a shifter, I can see it. I have to remember to switch to a shifter. Next time I'll be starting that game. I'm not really sure why I cannot do it during while the game is running, it's just a single switch on the shifter. But no, it has to be done before. RZ, the 97 one, I think it is, if I remember correctly. I didn't expect him to break there like that. The visibility behind that wheel is quite horrible. Would have been much better. More to go, and three more laps. Someone who's in the first place is quite far away there, in the corner already. That's Lambo Countach, P2. I would definitely prefer that Countach than a BMW in real life. Such a beautiful car. That in front, is Alpine, definitely a French driver. Oh no, it's BMW, isn't it? 4, I'm guessing. Two more laps, one more car, one more opponent. Best update braking. Went sideways there. So it's BMW versus BMW. At least I'm in the Bond car. And a final lap. And it's a win. 1:46, the best time. No idea how bad it is or how good it is. Probably somewhere there in average range. Good enough for me. Unfortunately, I didn't get the extra bonus. One of the this hit was too strong. 400 experience points left. And lost. Left on the track and lost. Fuji, so we're going to Japan. That would be good to have a Japanese car, I guess, then. Japanese car in Japan. Toyota. Toyota looks good, and I like the color. This one is red. Bold. Yeah, let's go with Toyota. Oh, and I didn't have to retune it. Good. It's all ready. Ready to go. Plug and play. Thank you. The only thing I may want to change is... Oh, that has puddles, right? That's too new to have any other type of gearbox. Let's put the braking to the front. I don't have idea where to stop braking here. That was good enough. So I moved from BMW Z8 to BMW Z4. I think they are twin cars, Z4 and the new Supra. That will take my bonus, I'll be really angry. Or I should have said if that takes my bonus away. Okay, 3rd and 9th second to the first one. B. Johnston, British guy. That person in second, what kind of luck is that? A cake? No idea. Never seen it before. Looks like a cupcake. Sideways. That costed me some time there. Working too early. I need to find that sweet spot. Porsche 911 GT3. To be honest, I doubt that Toyota would have any real chances with that Porsche in real life. Those GT3s are amazing cars, amazing. Completely different league than some kind of Toyota Supra. But do they have 7 gears? I do have 7 gears. Car. almost 5 second advantage. Oh no, it's getting on me now. Ah, it's too far away. Or it is too far away. No, it's AI. Car is very whoopy. Some kind of stabilizations would be good. Just use this one because it's so boring. Is there an 8th one? Oh, there is, cool. Oh, there is no 9th. Back to puddles. Does this car actually have an alternative shifter, like the sequential on the left-hand side, or just buttons? I'm curious now. Doesn't have anything there. Couldn't see anything. And we're done. That was the 3rd one, right? I'm falling asleep with this game. Oh my gosh. Oh, at least I got the bonus experience. What's next? Catalonia, Barcelona, Spain. I don't think I have Spanish cars, which would fit that. Are there actually any Spanish cars in this game? Yeah, I thought so. Maybe some Italian. Yeah, I could use 4C. That's a nice car. French. What am I doing? Here, country. France. French car, Alpine. I could use the Alpine. I've never used it before. Try the Alpine. France is so close, then yeah, I guess that makes sense. In the lack of Spanish cars, let's use a French one. Okay. Same old. Settings, that's done. Soft. Everything's done. That car is doesn't have a lot of horsepower, but it's light. We'll see how it works for it. I mean, lack speed on the long straights. Ah, it's puddles. Okay. Expect that to happen. Not in this car. That would be some kind of old Ferrari. And for sure. It is actually quite tail happy. Doesn't look like I'm missing, or I'm lacking in horsepower department. Skyline. And a Supra. Another Skyline. 34 this time. I think the other one was 33. I don't think it was a 32. And the AMG. 45. Lap 1 of 5. Finished. That coming. Got a bump at rear end. My eyes are closing. That's the last race. W game. Four. It's like the BMW is a car of choice for that tier of races. To him, I want my bonus 20% for 50% experience bonus. Stay in his aero tunnel. This is last lap, so this time I have to we're taking. There on the left. After I was on the grass when braking, would have done better. Okay, good. That was the 4 races is enough. On to see my daily reward. Oh, there was a handicap under the car. Was it 300 then? Didn't know. But I was driving 400 car. Oh, it was 300. Okay, cool. Cool. Good, extra experience. Oh wait, I already got a card today for my daily. Oh no, this is daily workout. I guess it'll be that hatchback there at the back. It's always like, I think it's Renault. Oh no, Supra, I have it already. This is all rigged. I don't believe this is fair game. Anyway, thank you all for watching. I'll be back later on for the Project Cars Tourist. Have a good evening.